haven't been long. It's long. We are so happy that you have chose to worship with us today, for we are a church that love God, love others, and serve the community. Amen. We will have our call to worship by Reverend Diane Pollard.
Sing praises to the Lord, O ye his saints, and give thanks to his holy name.
Oh,
hold on. No matter what the storm is, hold on. We will have our morning prayer by Reverend Sylvia Jones.
Let us bow our heads. Father, we stretch our hands to thee. There is no other help that we know. If thou withdraw thyself from us, whither shall we go? God, we just thank you right now for another day's journey. We thank you for keeping us last night and waking us up this morning early with your grace and your mercy. Father, we thank you for those who have come to this drive-in service. And we thank you for those who are joining us through the miracle of technology. And oh God, some are suffering right now. We ask that you reach down with your healing wings and touch them during this pandemic. And God, we ask for your Holy Spirit to come right now. Touch our speaker, Pastor Epps. Let there be a word from on high that somebody's life will be changed and touched. Somebody will be healed today. It is in the precious name of the Lord Jesus Christ that I do pray. Let us all say amen, amen, and amen.
Vacation. We are so glad to have with us today Dr. Vodricka Epps from the Mount Calvary Baptist Church. After the next gospel selection, the next voice you will hear will be that of Reverend Dr. Vodricka Epps. Hear ye him.
Finger. If there's a praise in you this morning, come on, why don't we let it out right about now? Oh, come on, we can do better than that. I said, if there's a praise in you this morning, why don't we let it out right about now? Amen, amen, amen. It's early in the morning and there's a praise in you. We ought to give God some praise on this morning. Amen, amen. We are certainly blessed to be in the house of the Lord on this morning in the absence of your pastor, the angel of this house. Can we please give God some praise for him? Amen. Reverend Dr. Norwood Carson. Amen. Amen. Friendship, we want you to know that this community has joined you in prayer for the passing of your first lady's father. Amen. We are in prayer with you. Amen. Our hearts go out to you, and we know that you're doing all that you can to support your first family. Amen. So we give God praise for that on this morning. I knew where I was coming this morning, and so because there's so many Cowboy fans over here at Friendship, we just, amen. I don't hear no horns blowing. I said because there's so many. See them Redskins fans, they get mad when them stars start coming out. Amen. Amen. We give God praise on this morning, on this sports day, Jersey day. We wanted to certainly represent them boys. Amen. Amen. We're not going to be before you long, and we certainly are not going to labor. We thank you for the opportunity to share. I want to, for the time that is ours this morning, I would like for us to go to Psalm 40. Psalm 40 this morning, for the time that is ours this morning, we want to share with you from Psalm 40, verses 1 through 3. Psalm 40 this morning, verses 1 through 3. I'm going to be reading from the New King James Version of the Holy Writ this morning. However, whatever translation you have, that would be just fine. Psalm 40, verses 1 through 3. The word of our God says, I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined to me and heard my cry. He also brought me up out of a horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and set my feet upon a rock and established my steps. He has put a new song in my mouth, a hymn of praise to our God. Many will see it and fear and will trust in the Lord. The grass withers and the flowers fade, but the word of our God will remain forever. Let us pray. God, we thank you now for this opportunity, God, that you've given us on this day to come and share. We thank you, God, for all of the praise and the praise dance and the prayers that have gone thus far. But now, God, on this early blessed morning that you have blessed us with, God, we want to hear a word from you. So we ask now that you come speak to us for just a little while. We'll be ever so careful to continue to give you the glory, the praise, and the honor. It is in Jesus' name. Might all God's children say amen. Come on, say amen again. Say amen one more time. Amen. Amen. My brothers and sisters, for as long as I can remember, music and singing have been a valuable part of our religious experience. Everybody loves some good singing and some good preaching. Song is important to our religious experience. It is so important that the Bible itself has 150 psalms sung by various people at various times in their lives. The songs of inspirations are broken down in what is commonly known as the five books. Book one, that's Psalm 1 through 41. The psalmist sings about how God is beside us. Book 2, Psalm 42 through 72. The psalmist sings about how God goes before us. Book 3, that is Psalms 73 through 89. The psalmist reminds us that God is all around us. Book 4, Psalm 90 through 106. The psalmist sings about how God is above us. And in Book 5, that's Psalm 107 through Psalm 150. The psalmist reminds us that God is among us. You see, brothers and sisters, when you understand the breakdown, you begin to understand that there is a song for every occasion. My mother understood this because no matter the situation she was faced with, she always had a song in her heart. There was always a song she would sing no matter what was going on in her life. When she did not know what else to do, she would pray and she would sing. I can still hear, I'm reminded this morning, I can still hear her singing old songs like "Trouble in My Way, I Have to Cry Sometime." I can still hear her singing songs like "This Little Light of Mine, I'm Going to Let It Shine." I'm reminded, I can still hear her singing, "I'm coming up on the rough side of the mountain, and I'm doing my best to make it in." You see, brothers and sisters, when mama couldn't see her way through, she would sing her way through. And I wonder this morning, on this mighty fine, blessed, beautiful day, does anybody have a song in their hearts this morning? Is there anybody singing during this time of double pandemic this morning? During this time where we continue to deal with COVID-19 and systematic racism. During a time where we continue to be treated as second-class citizens. During a time when deadly force is the primary force. During a time when black men are being shot in their back 7 times. During a time, brothers and sisters, when peaceful protesters are labeled as mobs and looters, but militias are labeled as defenders of the Constitution. Y'all don't want to help me. During a time when 17-year-old kids carry assault-style rifles, kill 2 people and injure another. During a time when we have a president that talks tough on violence, but not on the cause of the violence. What I want to know is that during these perilous times, is there anybody that still have a song in their heart? Am I talking to anybody this morning? I said, is there anybody during these perilous times that still have a song in their heart? I hear the old church singing this morning. They singing, "I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. His eyes are on the sparrow, and I know he watches me." And because, brothers and sisters, God is watching, I come here to proclaim today that we are coming out the pits. Yes, brothers and sisters, we're coming out of discrimination. We're coming out of voter suppression. We're coming out of police brutality. Things may not be the way we want them to be, but we are coming out of the pits. We may be crying and hurting right now. We may be shaking our head in disgust. However, today, let us raise our voice in song and declare we are coming out of the pits. We're coming out of the pits. That's what we see in our text today. God had rescued David from a horrible pit. And he wrote Psalm 40, which is in Book 1, to sing praise unto the Lord for what God has done. David in this psalm sings about a time in his life when he felt caught in a helpless and hopeless situation. However, in this time of uncertainty, in this time of insecurity, God heard him and God lifted him out. God set his feet. God gave him a solid place to stand, and God put a new song in his heart. Lord, have mercy. He put it in the
his heart. He put it in his mouth. And just quickly, just walk around the text with me for just a moment. And I believe that we would notice three movements regarding David coming out of the pit. First, we see David's patience. It's right there in verse 1. The Bible says, I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined to me and heard my cry. Notice the order outlined in Scripture this morning. The Bible says that David waited patiently on God. And as a result of his patience, God inclined to him and heard his cry. Brothers and sisters, it's no secret that David knew something about suffering, particularly suffering caused by his very own actions. However, David also knew who to turn to during times of trouble. David understood that even if we were unfaithful, God will remain faithful. Lord, have mercy. Therefore, when times of trouble arose, David turned to God and waited patiently on his help. The Bible says that he patiently waited on the Lord, which means he had the ability to wait without becoming impatient. Patiently waiting means that we are faithful to God. We are patiently waiting for things to happen in God's time, not our time. And I don't know about you this morning, but it's good news to know that when we are patient and wait on God, he inclines and he hears our cry. I want to see if I can help make it plain this morning. The story is told of a family that did not have food to eat. But mama set the table. Mama laid the plates out. She put out her silverware and she put out her glasses. She called the family and said, come and eat. The kids came in and sat at the table and they said, mama, where is the food? Mama replied to her family, to her kids. She looked at them and she said, hold on, baby, just be patient. And brothers and sisters, in that moment, there was a knock at the door. And the neighbor showed up and said, God told me to bless your family with a meal tonight. God, help me at all. I don't know about you, but that is just like our God. When he hears the cries of his people, he is inclined to help them, and he shows up in the nick of time. And Lord have mercy. I know where I'm at this morning, so I believe I got about two or three people who knows that God will show up on time. I said, I know where I'm at this morning. I said, I believe I got about two or three horn blowers who know that God will show up on time. He showed up in the operating room. He showed up in the relationships. He showed up in the finances. He showed up in your marriage. He showed up when you was down to your last dime. Come on, don't make me work too hard. He showed up when you were down and out. And when he shows up, brothers and sisters, he makes a way out of no way. Lord have mercy. When God shows up, he brings us out of desperation. He brings us out of despair. He brings us out of the pits. All you have to do is just patiently wait on the Lord. Not only was David patient, but he was patient, watch this, while he was in the pit. Oh, have mercy. I said, not only was he patient, but he was patient while he was in the pit. You see it, don't you? I know you see it because you still have your Bibles open. The Bible says in verse 2, he says, he brought me up out of a horrible pit. He says he brought me out of the miry clay and he set my feet upon a rock and established my steps. David was patiently waiting in a pit. God Almighty. This word pit means a sense of destruction. It is a sense of distress or dungeon. And while David was in the pits and patiently waiting, the Bible says God hears and inclines to him and brings him up out of the pits. Brings him up out of the miry clay, set his feet upon a rock and establish his steps. In other words, brothers and sisters, if I can say it like the old preacher would say, God brought him up, God stood him up, and then God tuned him up. I said, if I could just say it like the old preacher, I said, God brought him up, God stood him up, and then God tuned him up. And listen, I want to be clear this morning because I don't know what your pit is today. Maybe your mind is in a pit. Maybe it's a pit of bad habits. Maybe you have a pit of circumstances, a pit of defeat, a pit of sin, a pit of depression. I don't know what your pit may be, but what I do know is that all of us find ourselves in muddy and slimy pits from time to time. All of us find ourselves down and out. All of us find ourselves in dungeons. All of us find ourselves wondering and waiting on God to help us. Like Joseph, I got Bible to help me. Like Joseph, we may get thrown into a pit. Like David, we may slip into the pit. Like Elijah, we may find a pit and jump in. Or like Job, we may realize that life is the pits. The question is not will we face pits in life. No, that's not the question this morning. The question is, what do you do when you find yourself in a pit? I want to encourage you to follow David's example. Wait patiently on the Lord while you're in your pit, to cry out to God from the pits, because God hears and God helps and God will deliver on time. I hear the old church saying, he may not come when you want him, but he's always on time. I said, y'all want to help me? I said, he may not come when you want him, but he's always on time. Does anybody believe that you're coming out the pit on this morning? Am I talking to anybody that believes that you're coming out of the pit this morning? Look at the car beside you and tell them, say, I'm coming out of the pit this morning. Y'all don't want to say that. I said, look at the car beside you. Honk the horn, man, and say, baby, I'm coming out of the pit this morning. Lord, make it personal this morning. Say, I'm coming out the pit. You can talk about me as much as you please, but I'm coming out of the pit. I don't know when, I don't know how, but I do know that I'm coming out of the pit. No more pity parties. I'm going in a new direction. False narratives cannot stop me. False labels cannot stop me. Suffering cannot stop me. Unfair treatment cannot stop me. Discrimination cannot stop me. Lord have mercy, don't mess with me this morning. God is bringing me out. He's bringing me out of the pits. I'm done now. But not only was David patiently waiting while he was in the pits. Watch the text, brothers and sisters, because when God brought him out, he gave God some praise. Okay, I want to make sure we got that, because he was patiently waiting while he was in the pits. And when God brought him out, when God delivered him, he gave God some praise. You see it, don't you? It's right there in verse 3, the A clause of verse 3. The Bible says, he has put a new song in my mouth, a hymn of praise to our God. Brothers and sisters, David's gratitude at his deliverance, David's gratitude at God bringing him out of the pit, that David's gratitude and God hearing his cry, Lord have mercy, was that he had a song of praise on his lips. And when you think about, Lord Jesus, I feel my help coming on. When you think about the goodness of God, I said, when you think about the goodness of God, and all he's done for you, just like my mother used to sing, there ought to be a hymn of praise on your lips. And I'm wondering who I'm preaching to this morning. Is there anybody out there that still has a hymn of praise on your lips? Is there anybody out there that still sings Amazing Grace? Oh, have mercy, yeah. Is there anybody out there that still sings Blessed Assurance? Lord, have mercy, that Jesus is mine. Is there anybody out there that still sing In the Sweet By and By? I can't get no help this morning. Do you sing Because He Lives? I can't. Do you still sing It Is Well With My Soul? Lord, have mercy. There ought to be a hymn of praise on your lips. And I wonder, is there anybody singing thank you this morning? Lord, have mercy. I said, is there anybody singing thank you this morning? Thank you when you were up, and thank you when you were down. Sing thank you when all is well, and sing thank you when all goes to hell. Sing thank you till Jesus is magnified, and sing thank you till our God is glorified. And maybe I'm by myself this morning, but I thank God for hearing my cry this morning. I said, maybe I'm by myself this morning, but I thank God for hearing my cry. However, I'm reminded of a cry of one named Jesus this morning. You know Jesus, don't you? Does anybody in friendship still know Jesus this morning? Jesus, he was born in Bethlehem. Jesus, he was raised in Nazareth. He was baptized in the Jordan. He was tempted in the wilderness. The Bible says he preached in Galilee. He was tried in Caesar's court. He died on a hill called Calvary. He was buried in a borrowed tomb. And while he was in that tomb, I believe the Father heard the Son cry out. And as the Son patiently waited on the Father, I believe God inclined towards Jesus from the pits of the grave, reached down early one Sunday morning. I can't get nobody to help me. I said, I just believe that he heard him from the pits of the grave, and he reached down early one Sunday morning and told Jesus, he said, Son, you're coming out of the pits. He said, Son, I'm raising you up out of the grave. Good morning, friendship. May the good Lord bless you real good. But on my way down the road to Calvary, Lord have mercy, I feel my ride coming on. I said, on my way down the road to Calvary, I want you to know this morning that in the same manner that God brought Jesus out of the tomb, God will bring you out of the pit. Is anybody going to say something to me this morning? In the same manner
that God raised up Jesus, that's the same way that God is going to raise you up. The same God that raised Jesus from the dead is the same God who will raise you. And I want you to know that we're coming out of the pits. We're coming out of these pandemics. Don't you worry. Just patiently wait on God. He cares for you. He hears your cry. He will draw you out. He will pull you up. You're coming out of despair. You're coming out of depression. You're coming out of desperation. Y'all don't want to help me. Is anybody out there believe you're coming out today? Do you believe that you're coming out today? Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I'm coming out. I'm coming up out the pits. I'm tired of being down. I'm tired of being depressed. I'm tired of these pandemics. I'm ready to get back in God's house. I'm ready to give God some praise. I'm ready to clap my hands. I'm ready to stomp my feet. I'm ready to blow my horn. If you're ready to blow your horn, then blow your horn for God this morning. He's worthy of all your praise. Brothers and sisters, we're coming out of the pits. I know we're tired. I know there's so much going on in the world. Every time we turn on the news, somebody else is dying. Every time we look up, even in our very own community of Hopewell, homicides, people are dying. There seems to be no good news these days. But this morning I come with good news. I come to tell you this morning that we're coming out of the pits. I come to tell you this morning, just patiently wait on the Lord. He hears your cry and he will deliver you. He will bring you up. He will set your feet upon a rock. And when he sets your feet upon a rock, you'll be standing on a rock that does not roll. The word of God for the people of God. Praise be unto God.
Want to be coming out of the pit. Maybe you're tired. You're tired of going through what you're going through. But this morning, you have an opportunity to give your life to Christ. And we say, God, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for this message. For those who have joined us today here in the parking lot or listening to our live stream and Zoom conference call, perhaps there is someone who have never accepted Jesus Christ. Today, we have that opportunity. We ask God that you would just bless them and give them what they stand in need of. God, we ask that you would comfort them. Today, you can confess, Lord Jesus, I repent of my sin. Come into my life. Wash me clean. I make you the Lord and Savior of my life. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you have made that decision today, please reach out to the Friendship Baptist Church website and contact us. We'll be more than glad to walk with you through this journey. If Friendship is not the church for you, we have no problem getting you involved in a Bible-based church. Amen. Before we leave, just want to remind you of next week. Next week, our service will be in the building. And service will return to our 10 a.m. start time. A few notes that we need to be sure of. You must wear a mask throughout the service. You must keep 6 feet distance. And you must wash your hands going in and coming out in Jesus' name. Amen. As we're about to leave from this place, but never from his presence, we'll be giving our offering as you leave, and we will bless those that have been able to give, and we ask that God would just bless what we receive today. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for the gifts, and we thank you for the giver. And God, may it be acceptable in your sight. And God, as we're about to leave, we pray, Father, the Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face to shine upon us and be gracious unto us. The Lord lift up his countenance upon us and give us peace this day and forevermore. Amen. Amen. We want to thank everyone that had a part in getting things straight for this morning, as well as thanking Dr. Epps for that fine message this morning. Please follow the directions of our security as you exit. Amen and amen.